Today, I suddenly felt that I was typing too slow, and so I decided to finally change that. Typing, huh? I currently type at a speed of 50 words per minute with the primitive hunt and peck technique, where you search for the key and press it. And 50 is pretty respectable speed, but... yeah, that's the exact reason why I decided to practice touch typing for 4 weeks and see my improvements. So, to start this journey, I did a quick little Google search on touch typing and discovered two really helpful websites, RutterType and keybr. RutterType was what got me started on touch typing, taught me the correct posture and finger positioning along with their respective typing areas. It was extremely helpful, but keybr was the key of my training. You use an algorithm to determine which keys you need more practice on and provides you more keys to practice as you master more. Anyways, here is 4 weeks of touch typing condensed into 7 tips. Tip 1. Persistence is key. You'll be more prone to errors when starting out, but persistence is key and practice makes perfect. You just have to keep practicing and take errors as a grain of salt. You definitely get better as you progress and get to know more about the layout of the keyboard. Tip 2. Always return to home row. Always return to the home row of the keyboard. If you don't know what that means, it's basically the state where your fingers are on the keys A, S, D, F, J, K, L, semicolon. The F and J key of the home row where your indexes are supposed to be are designed with a bump on them to make finding them easier while not looking. Try not to move too far away from the home row each time you're typing a word so that you don't get lost. Tip 3. Accuracy, not speed. Aim for accuracy, not for speed. If you're not doing well on certain keys, try to slow down and hit the key correctly. The purpose of practicing is to develop muscle memory of each key, and if you're not hitting the keys with accuracy, you're not going to be able to train it, or worse, you train it to the wrong key. So, train your finger positioning, use the right fingers for the right areas. For example, don't use your middle finger to hit the O key, use your ring finger. This was a mistake which I kept making. Tip 4. Don't strain yourself. Take a break when needed, don't strain yourself too much, and trust me, you'll perform much better after a short break. Take a short walk or maybe just a few deep breaths, close your eyes, lay back, and relax your fingers for a moment. You might be doing badly because your fingers are simply fatigued from too much training, so come back with an energized version of yourself and continue. Tip 5. Keyboard type. Use a keyboard whose keys won't get pressed accidentally, aka use a keyboard with a higher actuation force. So I found that when I'm practicing, I kept accidentally hitting the wrong key when I was using a membrane keyboard, so I switched to a mechanical one with a higher actuation force, and sure enough, I was making a lot less mistakes. Now, I'm not saying that you absolutely need to use a mechanical keyboard. If you want to use a membrane keyboard, or if you're typing on your laptop's keyboard, that's totally fine. I'm actually doing good even on my laptop's keyboard after the beginning stages of the training. So if you feel that higher actuation force is taxing on your fingers, go for membrane keyboards. And also, if you feel like mechanical keyboards are too tall for your wrist, get a wrist rest to ease the strain. It makes it a lot more ergonomic to type on. Plus, typing on mechanical keyboards just be way more satisfying. Tip 6. Word by word. Type word by word, not letter by letter. Touch typing should be a fluent motion of the fingers to type out an entire word, not a single letter. So break the text you want to type into words and type them out. This is also where I would like to point out that keybr isn't the best for training to type entire words, as its algorithm gives you gibberish to type. So, that's where monkeytype comes in. It's a website for you to test your typing speed and it gives you actual words. Plus, it's got tons of customizations. Or, if you're training for coding, try speedtyper.dev. It's got C, C++, Go, Java, JavaScript, Python, Ruby, Rust, Scala, and TypeScript integrated. Tip 7. Do not look. Do not look at your keyboard, don't pick down, not at all. This tip builds on the muscle memory concept. If you pick down, you're not going to train your muscle memory. So, even if you can't seem to find a key, never pick. If needed, use the keyboard guide in keybr to find the key. Also, try to apply tip number 2, return to home row. I used to find myself constantly picking down when I can't find a key, and to solve that, I draped a piece of cloth over both my hands covering the keyboard so that every time I looked out, I'll see the cloth and be reminded that I was supposed to touch type. And that was it. 7 tips from 4 weeks of training. I hope you train more effectively after these tips, and if possible, tell me your progress of 4 weeks of training in the comments section down below. My 4 weeks of training, by the way, got me from 50 words per minute hunt and peck to 58 words per minute touch typing. I'll definitely continue to train, but for now, I'm out, and until next time.